on the Real.
It's girl chat gone wild. Yo, Tay was standing there butt naked.
And breaking news, we're talking real news. A match is made if one client likes the scent of another and the nasal attraction is mutual.
Ooh, this one smells like Idris.
And we've got some killing deals for you. These are coming with me on my next trip for sure.
Plus, the slickest fashions for all those April showers.
The Real. Tay, well, before we get into all that, last month we all talked about what it would be like to have our own day.
Yeah.
And Tay, you were pretty detailed about the whole things. If you guys haven't seen it, you have to watch this. If you had your own holiday, Tamar Braxton Day, what would be the order of business?
It would be like National Tamar and Margarita Day.
Nice.
Yes. A free happy hour, but at work.
Oh, nice. Ooh. So everybody gets to have
everybody's
a drink.
Everybody's excited, but everybody's still working.
How Hallelujah. Can we make that happen?
Listen, well, party people, guess what?
What?
It had happened. I was recently honored in the great state of Arkansas, and I'm proud to say, guess what? April 2nd is officially Tamar Braxton Day. And I brought proof. I got a plaque and everything. Yes. Oh my gosh. It's right here. Yes, me and my sister went to Arkansas for a fashion show. And, you know, unbeknownst to me, the Secretary of the State came out with this award and was like, it's Tamar Braxton Day today. And I thought, you look at testament when you put things out there in the universe, it can come back. So why should you say or pray for the things and say the things that you want? Because it comes.
Amen.
So now guess what? I feel a margarita coming on.
That is amazing.
Yes. You want to see my flag?
Yes.
Let's see your flag.
It's super duper big.
Uh-huh.
And it's amazing.
It's very official.
That's good.
You tried. You tried.
No, I love that.
Yeah, you know, it was just so great because, you know, I went to Arkansas one time before on tour with R. Kelly, and it was great. And this actually was like a charitable event.
Uh-huh.
And it was just about putting the arts back in schools.
Wow.
And since that's not happening during the summertime, it's a day camp for the kids to go and have.
Wow.
I remember camp was bomb.
Yes. Summer camp?
Yes. Right. And so this allowed for 30 kids to go for a whole month.
Oh, that is awesome.
Yes. Isn't that amazing? It's amazing. Yeah.
We need to make it for all 50 states. So I'm going to put it out there. I want all 50 states to start doing a Tamar Braxton Day. All right?
It was a good time. My Tamar Braxton collection was in the fashion show. It was very cute. So I just want to thank the state of Arkansas once again for honoring me with my own day.
So awesome.
And, you know, I don't even know what I did to deserve this particular blessing, you know, but I'm just so grateful and I love you so much.
Wow.
Now, I just want to ask y'all something.
What?
Yes. Are y'all going to celebrate Tamar Braxton Day with me next year?
Absolutely. Yes. Listen,
I
know. Dinner since we have in LA now.
Yes, yeah. And I know my Tamartian friend's going to be there, so it's going to be turned to the up.
Absolutely. Okay. I love that.
That's such a cool feeling. Congratulations, Tay.
Thank you, baby Kate.
Congratulations again on your achievement, Tamar.
Now,
from being honored to straight up disrespected, Republican presidential candidate Donald Trump is in the news again.
She said
everybody
it.
Said, oh. She said
more Lord. Specifically, you guys, his star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. Now, apparently, it is constantly vandalized and has even been urinated and defecated on.
Oh, my Whoa. God. Kanye shrugged.
Now, yo. I read on VanityFair.com that there's a rumor the star allegedly requires so much cleanup that it may be removed. Clearly, I am not a Trump fan, but it's unlikely that this would happen, and it's just a rumor. But, Tamara, do you think Donald Trump's star should be removed since it's such a nuisance?
I didn't even know he had a star.
Me either.
I didn't either. Wait, I'm gonna be honest. I don't know why I thought that stars were for actresses,
Hollywood.
For the arts.
Hollywood.
Actors,
for the arts. Actresses, he was a real musicians. Estate agent.
Real estate he was a reality show star.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, he
I get
only
that.
Had like 6 seasons. Sit down.
But I heard that you could buy. I heard that if you have enough money, you could actually buy your own star.
It does cost $30,000 to buy a star.
You My can husband buy told me your own star.
People buy
That's
their
cheating.
Own
star.
And you have to get signatures and stuff like that, but yeah.
Oh, okay.
Wow. So maybe he bought his own.
I mean, listen, not only should they remove his star, they need to remove him from the presidential cabinet. He's out of control. No shade. No shade. I don't know, really, and I'm going to speak to everybody in America right now. I don't know what we're doing because everybody says how much they can't stand him. You know, he's not a good representation for, you know, us as Americans. But why come for? Are you still voting for him? So, you know, in my opinion,
so
take
confused.
This energy and go to the polls and vote. This is where your voice can be heard.
Yeah.
Because this is just ridiculous.
Very confusing.
I mean, I just want to wake up one day and be like, okay, that was a joke.
Nope.
That was a little funny, but not really. Because it's not funny
anymore. It's like the longest SNL skit ever.
Ever. In the words of my good friend NeNe Leakes, bye wig. All right, people with controversial hairstyles. Justin Bieber really recently made a change to his signature blonde hairdo that people have taken an issue with. Yep, that's right, party people. His locks are now locks. Yes. Some people are saying that Justin's locks are cultural appropriation, but Justin disagrees, and I think I do too. There's a video of Bieber backstage at the iHeartRadio Awards talking to Big Sean about it. He's saying, people saying you just want to be black and all that stuff, and I'm like, it's just my hair, right? Like, Lonnie, what do you think about Justin's new hairstyle?
Well, I think there's a difference between cultural appropriation and cultural assimilation. And when I was in corporate America, I could not wear my hair in an afro because it was considered inappropriate. It was considered unprofessional.
Yeah. And that's sad.
So what happened was I had to assimilate, and a lot of us have to assimilate in this country. So when they, you know, criticize and they say, well, you know, black women, you guys, you are taking European cultures. What we're doing is assimilating. So I'm just saying that because I want to explain the difference in my view between assimilation and appropriation.
These are big words.
Because it's what he's doing, what they consider cultural appropriation is when the minority, the majority, takes the minorities, you know.
Take it as their own?
Yeah. And then they
claim
just poo-poo
it. They claim it as their own.
They claim it as on a poo-poo it. So that's why some people got upset with him saying that. He's saying, oh, it's just my hair. But a lot of people feel like locks are, you know, locks have been around since the Vikings. But they've been known more recently for the Rastafarians.
Yes.
So a lot of people are looking at it from that point of view. But ultimately, it is his hair. But it is some form of appropriation.
Yeah, but
that he's
this
doing.
Analytical conversation for some.
Because
hell?
People need to understand. Because he needs to understand where it comes from.
That's
why people were upset when he said it like that. It's like he doesn't understand where it comes from.
Do you think they would straightening your hair?
Do you think they wouldn't be upset if he would just simply say, I was inspired by this particular culture or this
Maybe.
Particular time it's to wear my hair like this?
Do you think that you have to explain
no,
your
I'm
hairstyle?
Just I'm just
okay,
asking.
But no,
I'm
but
asking
I'm saying,
for the people who are
yeah,
upset.
Yeah, the people that were
do
upset.
Do you guys think you have to explain your hairstyle?
If he explained it.
Okay, I just want to hear that because...
Yeah. Any of you offended by Justin Bieber's hair? You
guys, yeah, I think it's amazing to me, my
When
opinion.
I was younger, when I grew up, when I was six, right out the bat, my mom knew that I loved curly hair, and I curled it all the time with rods. And then when I got got older, about 8, I had straight up perms that we did at home. And then when I turned 16, I actually went and I got locks because I loved it so much. And it's, and to me, it was just a hairstyle. And so I just don't, I don't want people, it might, yes, of course it is culturally inspired, but
you gotta understand, because he's a performer, things like that, people are putting a lot into it.
I will say this about millennials, and this is what I love about millennials, and he is a millennial.
Right.
Millennials don't see color. They just
do.
What they want to do.
As they should.
And I love that about them. I really do.
They
do, yes. They just do what they want to do. They're like, that's dope. Yeah. So I'm gonna do that too.
That is so true. So you guys might be staring at Justin Bieber's hair, but have you ever caught yourself staring at someone super sexy? I think somebody here is guilty for a little longer than you should. Well, I know, right? When someone's real good looking. Well, research has actually shown that staring at someone can actually make them more attractive to you. Oh, yeah. The study done by Harvard says that we base someone's attractiveness by how much time we spend looking at their face. So, Aid, do you think this is true? Absolutely. I have a staring problem. My name is Adrian Bailon, and I have a staring problem. I don't know if it's a... I've had it since I was little. Like, literally, my sister would be like, Adrian, you're gonna get us jumped in New York. She's like, stop staring at people. But so now I just tell people what I'm staring at, because I'll notice that they notice I'm staring. So I'll be like, girl, you're just really pretty. Like, you're just so pretty.
Yeah.
Just letting you know, that's why I'm staring at you. Don't beat me up. Let me let you know I'm looking at you because I think you're really beautiful. But I think it absolutely is true. Have you ever spent time with somebody that maybe at first you didn't find so attractive, and then you spend more time with them, and you look at them more, and then you turn and you're like, gosh, I really find that person to be so
beautiful. My mother said that. Yeah, you know, my mother's single, and I'm looking for a stepdaddy, so, you know, we're trying to set her up with whomever. And she's like, no, I don't want to even, like, go there with a guy that I'm not attracted to, because then I might find him attractive later, and then I know that he's ugly in real life.
Oh, wow.
So, no, really. And I was like,
oh my God.
Well, look at God. That makes sense. You know, it's like, and she was like, let me explain it to you. Yeah, because I could. I was like, and she was like, it's like going into a house that stank. You ever fried fish in a house that smell like fish?
Yes.
So while you in the house, you don't know the house smell like fish.
That's so good.
That's so true.
That's
just
true.
You go outside the house and come back in the house, you realize your house is fishy. That's what you do with an ugly person.
It's so true.
They become fine.
But it's really like beauty is in the eye of the beholder, meaning that, like, when you get to know the person, you really can find somebody that maybe you didn't think originally was beautiful.
Because I dated this really, really, really hot guy at first, and then I kept staring at him, and then his attitude was just so stank, like the fish smell. But after a while, I was like, oh my God, you are ugly. You're not cute at all.
Yes,
you have a nasty attitude.
It's so true.
So I think you go the
other
way, too.
Staring, and they look better the more you stare.
Really? You just get used to their looks.
Oh, really? Y'all gonna throw that up? That picture? Really?
I have a problem. It's okay.
No, they look better to me when I'm drunk. You have to think you're drunk and you're like, ooh.
Come on.
Yes.
Lonnie love, you own the something.
Yes.
Okay.
Wait, hey, can I tell the story of what happened this morning?
I don't know, but
then you wake up in the morning, you be like, what did I do? Oh my God.
Wait, tell the story.
No, okay. What's the story?
You guys, okay, so this just happened this morning. So every time we have lunch, you know, we figure out what we're all eating, but I was craving something hearty that I thought maybe Tay would have and just, like, share with what she's having, right? So I went over to her room just for a second to bust open the door and be like, you're gonna order a tuna scoop today? Because today she's eating healthy. And I thought I was just gonna pop in, find out, and then pop out. Yo, Tay was standing there. Butt naked. Like, not naked, naked. But I...
Oh, you busted my room!
But I wasn't ready for it, so I opened the door and I was like, oh, Jesus. You guys, it was like the glory goddess of beauty. Like, I'm not playing.
Like, you're supposed to go like this and close the door. Yo. Jeannie gonna stand there like this.
No, and then I even asked, and her stylist was like, yo, you, like, gaze and stare. And I
dropped my eyes and I was like, oh, Lord, that's what a woman should look like. It was, I said, dude. Okay.
Told me. Creed star Michael B. Jordan recently spoke out on relationships in an interview with GQ, saying that at his age, he is focusing on his career before a relationship. Michael said, I try and be focused. I told myself at a young age, once I kind of saw this momentum that I would sacrifice all my 20s to my work. He also said, a lot of the women didn't agree with his choice. And when that happens, a man can feel rushed. So Jeannie, have you ever rushed a guy into a relationship when he wasn't ready?
Absolutely. I have, because I love love, and I love flirting, and I love, like, the dating stage and all the things that happen after you like somebody and what happens between, you know, getting to boyfriend stage.
I think rushing men does nothing but make them resent you.
Yes.
Wait,
today.
Hold on. Can you explain to me how you rush a man into a relationship?
I don't know, because I don't know no men that do things that they don't want to do. You could barely get them to do the things they do want to do.
Thank you. Come on, somebody.
But I don't know what rushing, how that works.
There are a lot of women...
Is rushing asking them, okay, where are we going with this?
No, that's
is that rushing?
That's defining the relationship. That's important.
Well, what's rushing?
Well, then how do you rush a man
into a relationship? Yeah, I don't know how to do that.
Some women start doing this about the ring...
That is
like
true.
...like 6 months in, because they're just in their late 30s and they really want to rush to the altar.
Well...
I know a lot
of people. So they manipulate things to move quicker. I know I've kind of, I didn't rush a guy, but I wanted to change a guy. I know sometimes a lot of women do that.
Oh, yeah, we always makeover men.
Yeah, like you guys heard of missionary dating. It's like when you're a Christian and then you date a nun. You've never heard of that?
I never heard of no missionary date.
Well, you tell.
You don't know what that is?
Where you try to get a man.
Where you try to get a man, you know, equally yoked, where you try to get a man to go to church.
Yes.
But he doesn't want to have anything to do with church. So I remember doing that.
Missionary.
And we called it missionary dating. You know, because, you know, you're missionary.
You're on a mission.
You're on a mission to get him to be a Christian, saved, to go to church.
So you can be with him.
Yes, don't do that, please.
Oh, no.
Don't do that. It is rough.
It's not real.
It's not worth it. You always just end up crying.
He backslides, huh?
Well, no, and it just never works out because initially, like you said, they take it out on you. They're like, I didn't even want to do this anyway. And then you're constantly like,
I
ain't
want to get saved.
Right.
You're preaching most of the time instead of really enjoying your relationship.
Every girl does that.
Every girl has done that.
Excuse me, what you mean you're preaching all the time instead of enjoying your relationship?
Meaning you're like, oh my gosh, have you heard of Jesus? Jesus loves you. Like that.
You pulling out Bible quotes
all the time.
Yeah.
Or like, have you ever taken a man to church just to feel out like how comfortable he is with the spirituality? So you're up there, you're
raising
and worshiping,
your hand.
And then you got
Tamara,
your eye open to check out if he's comfortable with all this. If I get down with the Lord, right?
What? Because I have never, and my father and my mother,
the
pastors of their own church, and I have never heard of missionary dating.
You never heard
you
of that?
You are a legend. I have never, for real. That
we
is
did it all the
amazing.
Time. No, a lot of my Christian friends, because we couldn't find any Christian men in church,
that's
so we would
very,
try to
convert them.
We
yeah.
try to convert
that's
them.
That's a very real example of
rushing. You go to single ministry and ain't nothing but women there, so
yes.
you go out and find some men.
Especially when you're like 16,
yeah.
you know?
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
But when mix that with door-to-door ministry, it's phenomenal. knock on the door.
You know the saying, April showers bring May flowers?
Yes,
of course. Of course. Well, April is just beginning, so that means we've got a whole month to get through before we can put the umbrella away. But just because it's raining cats and dogs doesn't mean you can't look fierce. Today, we've got the hottest, most stylish rainy day look that will have you hoping for some clouds. This is Rainy Runway.
Yes,
there are puddles of cute rain boots and jacket options out there. Tay-Tay, what's up first?
Well, Jeannie, my, don't get stuck with some boring, shapeless rain boots and cold combo. Make that wet pavement your own personal runway, child. Watch this. Come on out here, girl. Yes! That jacket is anything but ordinary. The chevron design is guaranteed to make you stand out in a crowd of solid colored raincoats. And the attached hood is key to keep you stylish and dry. And check out, y'all, these raincoats. glitter designs are so stylish, you'll want to wear them rain or shine. Mm-hmm. This jacket, guess what? Cost $77. And it's from ASOS. And the Jeffrey Campbell glitter boots that I love and gotta have in my closet is only $55. Awesome. Thanks, girl. You look absolutely amazing and ready for the rain.
Looking for that perfectly feminine rainy day look? You don't want to miss this. Come on out here and show us, girl. This single-breasted rain trench coat is so cute. Its polka dot pattern is fun and flirty, but it still comes with classic details like the belted cuffs and a button-down storm flap. This jacket doesn't have a hood, so don't forget your umbrella. This one has a sunny day pattern on the inside, so when you look up, you won't even notice the rain. Pair the jacket with these fashionable floral rain boots, and you'll be looking for puddles to jump in.
Yes.
The jacket is by London Fog and costs $129.90. The umbrella is from Amazon for $19.95, and the boots are from DSW, and they're just $64.95. Thank you.
I want that whole outfit.
So cute.
Yes, our final look is for the fierce fashionista who never wants to lose her unique sense of style just because of a little rain. Come on out. The printed jacket is super high fashion. It's lightweight and its zipper accents keep you feeling dry yet totally fashion forward. And just because this has soft pastel colors doesn't mean you can't go edgy with the boots. These waterproof combat boots are all the rage, rain or shine. Looking for that perfect finishing touch? You'll never want your leather purse to get caught in the rain, right?
Right.
So rock a waterproof purse like this one.
Cool.
Yes, it's waterproof. It's functional fashion at its best. The jacket is from ASOS and costs $77. The boots are from DSW for $44.95. And this purse is $59.99 from Macy's.
That is so
Thank
cool.
Thank you, girl.
I love that purse.
I need those boots.
Right? Okay, let's take one last look at our rainy day girls. Don't they look great?
Yeah.